Hello, my crafty friends. It's Andrea from Prairie Sky Paper Crafts, your independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Manitoba. So today I have our final Halloween treat idea. For this one, we're going to be using the coffee cups. And I have a cat punched out from our cat punch. It's punched out in the black glitter paper that's available in the current holiday mini catalog. And I'm also going to be using some of this spiderweb looking ribbon. So let's get started. We're not stamping for this one, but we are just creating. And you can tuck this with anything that you want. Some candies, hot chocolate, tea, if you're giving it to an adult, maybe a little mini adult sized beverage. So let's get started. I'm going to move everything off to the side. I do have paper towel in an old paper pumpkin box to catch some of the overspray, as well as some paper towel over my desk. I am using actually the Memento water-based acid-free re-inker in one of our little spritz bottles. I did try with the other re-inkers as well, and it worked really, really well. So let's hope the black turns out as well as the other ones did. All right, so we're just going to take and spritz all over our cup. Now, there are parts of the cup that have wax or something similar on it, so those parts will not get inky. You can run the risk of getting ink on your fingers, but when you're crafting, that's always a risk. So now I'm just going to let it drip a little and then just kind of move it around. Now, if you wanted to, and if you had time, you can absolutely just let it air dry. That's what I did with the first one, and it really didn't take that long at all. But I'm going to speed the process a little bit with our heat tool. Now, I will caution that because it is a lined cup, you do want to move quickly, and you don't want to keep in one spot for too long because you don't want to melt anything on the inside. And you can keep going with this to achieve whatever color that you're looking for. Once it's dry, if it's not as dark as I want it to be, I will go over it again. And you can just see how quickly the water is kind of drying up on this. The areas that are a little bit thicker, it does take a little bit longer for it to dry. It's not a big deal. All right, so that's mostly dry. It's more gray than the black that I was hoping to achieve. So I'm just going to grab the spritz bottle and spritz it again. And then you can just keep doing this and building up the color as much as you'd like. I would, if I was doing this for more than one person, I would totally do it assembly line style. Spray everything outside would be good if it was nice weather, then you don't have to worry quite so much about the overspray. Excuse me. And then just let everything dry, and then I would go ahead and start the next steps. But because this is just one today, it's not going to take very long at all. And I do like the mottled look that it gets. Now, you can decorate it however you wanted to. If you have pumpkin pie, re-inker, or even Cajun Craze would look really nice. Okay, so I think I'm happy actually with the two rounds of the spritz. I'm just going to make sure that it's good and dry because we do want to make sure. Oops. I have command hooks on the side of my desk, and I just hook my heat tool onto that. Okay, so I'm going to move our paper pumpkin box out of the way now, as we are done with that. And I'm just going to wipe off the top, or bottom, I guess, If you were concerned about this as well, you could punch out a circle or cut out a circle to cover any of the areas that I accidentally got a little bit more spray than intended. Okay, so our cup is done. I'm gonna move our paper towel out of the way. It is dry. It's just a little damp at the seam, but that's all right. It'll dry in plenty of time. Now these do come with the lids. I will caution, if you wanted to decorate the lids, you could do it either with paper, or you can use your alcohol ink. If you use alcohol inks though, I would let the person know who is the recipient that it's not food safe and they should not drink out of it if you use that. I would not use the Memento because it's water-based and it doesn't really adhere very well to glossy surfaces. Stays on might work, but I'm just going to leave our lid white for this one. Okay, now I've got our cat. I'm just going to keep this very basic with some black and some silver. And we're just going to do a little bit of a decoration with our ribbon. So what I'm going to do, now I am going to cover it with the cat. So a little bit of adhesive, and then I'm going to put the ribbon on. Because it's a web type ribbon, obviously the adhesive is not going to be a really tight fit or completely covered. So you can, you can kind of move it around and play with it a little bit. I love this ribbon, so I have a few spools of it. I'm just going to try. Actually, I think we're just going to do one round. Kind of makes it look not too overdone. All right. Now, the ribbon does tend to stick to itself. So just a word of caution with that. It's really, really lovely to work with though, and incredibly forgiving. I didn't do that one quite tight enough. You can just play with it a little bit with your fingers and pry it apart. I need to put a little bit more adhesive there, I think. There we go. One of those days where it feels like there's not enough coffee in the world, which is really bizarre because I don't drink a ton of it, like maybe 2 cups a day, but today is definitely feeling like more. Although I just got back from going to check on the chickens, and my lovely little whippet dog decided that she was going to drink my coffee for me today, which was super awesome. She's got a stomach made of lead, I swear, because nothing seems to impact her at all. Okay, so we're going to put some adhesive on our cat, and we're going to just cover up our connection. And I'm going to leave the tail without any adhesive on it, just so that it has a little bit of dimension. So if you wanted to, you could call it there, but I am going to grab a Sharpie and my white pearls, and we're going to make some googly eyes. You could use any color that you wanted, or if you had actual googly eyes, you could totally use them as well. I'm going to grab my take your pick. Now, I am also holding a customer appreciation event over on my Facebook page this week, actually Sunday at 1 p.m. Central, so I would love it if you could pop over. It's an event off of my page. Everybody is welcome. There's going to be lots of games, lots of fun. The only caveat is prize winners have to be from Canada. I'm not allowed to ship anything outside, but everybody is welcome to attend the event. So that is our white googly eyes. I think I'm just going to add some black dots too. Why not? The black dots just add just a little bit more sparkle. Well, not really sparkle, but they give a little bit more dimension and interest. All right, so there you go. Our cup is done. If you wanted to, you could just rinse the top out either with a little bit of rubbing alcohol on a piece of paper towel or some water. Or you can also decorate the inside. I prefer just to put treats on the inside. So there's our little Halloween treat cup. I hope you've enjoyed all of the Halloween treat bag ideas that I've had. There is one on YouTube from Monday, and the other one is over on my Facebook page. The link is down below. So don't forget to hit subscribe so you're notified every single time a brand new video comes up. And be sure to sign up for my email list as well. I have lots of really cool, fun ideas in there, as well as information about upcoming classes and specials. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day.